Dear students and friends, welcome to my session on PLC in 21 days. We are on day 19. In today's session, we'll see about the usage of linear actuators in PLC, a demonstration. Now, for that, I already prepared a video. I'll show that video. So here, okay, let me open this in some other PLC player, so then that will be still better, I personally feel. Okay, so here now you see I used two different linear actuators. Actually, please kindly make a note. This is the PLC and this is the power supply, supplying the power not only to this PLC, also to the this linear actuator. There are two linear actuators here. This linear actuator, it is basically a solenoid. Its stroke is only limited to 10 mm, 1 centimeter or 10 mm. So you can see a rubber band. The rubber band acts as a spring. So once the logic is, once it is energized, once the power is supplied, this core will move in the left hand side up to 10 mm, okay, at a very faster rate. The acceleration is very fast. So this is one kind of thing. It is working on 220 volt AC type. This one is a 24 volt DC linear actuator with a stroke of 100 mm actually. So this will move 100 mm. Again, to activate it, there is a trick here. I said it is a 24 volt DC, no? If you give a power supply of plus minus, there is plus to plus, minus to minus, it will move in the forward direction. If you reverse the polarity, in plus you give minus voltage, in minus you give plus voltage, then it will be returned back. It will be in the return stroke. Okay, so for that I used a single pole two channel relay boards here. Actually, there are two relay. Even though this PLC is a relay type PLC, I use these two additional relays. It is essential for this particular 24 volt DC type linear actuator. It is having a pushing or pulling capacity of more than 10 kg. It can lift a weight of 10 kg actually. Okay, so why I use this one is this relay, you know. See, it is having the polarity I have to change, right? So in the forward stroke, in the plus I have to give positive voltage. In minus, I have to give negative voltage or zero voltage. But when it comes to the return stroke, I have to reverse the polarity. So that is why I used you will be using a DPDT switch, a double pole, double terminal switch. You know, it is having a single channel, double terminal relay output. We can get it. If you use that kind of relay module, then only it is possible for you to change the polarity as you wish. That is why you used a single channel double terminal relay board. Okay, again, there are four buttons. I'll tell you the action now, but before that, this is the program. This is the ladder logic program. For X1, for actuator means this one. This is also an actuator, but I call this as solenoid. Once the actuator is the signal is pressed, X1, I think here this is the X1. I think we'll see that. Then this program will start. M11 is initiated. M11 will work for 4 seconds. Okay, so in 4 seconds, this will move in the forward direction. There we will see that M11 M11 is connected to, you see the output, M11 is connected to Y1. So linear actuator in forward direction, right? In M13, the linear motor will be in the reverse direction. I have to change the polarity, that's the thing. So M11 works for 4 seconds, 40, K40 means 4 seconds. Then a brief delay of 0.3 second, after that M13 starts. So M13 is linked with the Y2, the reverse motion for the same linear actuator, M13, right? Again, this M13 is actually not for 4 seconds, it is 4.1 seconds. Why I gave 0.1 second extra, you know, it is to have some cushion, right? That is about this one. Then you see that in the return stroke, I added one more internal number, M15. We'll see about what is M15 now. Okay, from that you will come to know about what is M15. Yes, this is M15. Linear home M15. Linear home M15 means this is the reset or linear home, because why I did this one, you know, suppose it is functioning. It is working now, it has moved to say, it is supposed to move 100 mm actually, and it has to return back 100 mm. But in between, if there is any power failure, then upon power resumption, it will start from here. Suppose it has moved, now this is the zero position, right? Once you trigger, then it will move for 100 mm. Wait for 0.3 seconds and it will return back. But in this process, if there is any power failure in between, so this actuator will be somewhere between 0 to 100. It has to be brought to home position. For that only, I have given this X4 for the return stroke especially. So the return stroke only makes the actuator to come to the home position. So then I introduce this one, right? So this is about the linear actuator. We'll see about the solenoid. Solenoid Y0 is a solenoid. Okay, M21. You see where is M21? M21. Then if I put for the actuator, I used X1. For solenoid, I used X0. Then in X0 also, I used the falling pulse. Because what is the falling pulse? I already told you. Suppose say if this is X0, yeah, this is the X0 button. I am pressing and holding. I am pressing. That means signal started. But M21 will not function, because it is not a normal pulse, it is a falling pulse, it is not even racing pulse. So again I repeat, if I press the racing pulse, I am holding, it is a pulse. In these two occasions, this will not function. Only at the time of releasing my finger from the button, I get the, this system will get the falling pulse. That time only this line will be executed. Okay, so this line will be executed just for 0.1 seconds only, just for 0.1 second, and it holds for 2 seconds, I think so. But let us see, yeah, 0.1 second only, M21 only, right? So just 0.1 second is sufficient to trigger this one, okay? So this is how we made the program from the ladder logic. Then all the circuitries and all, it is made. Now let us see it in action. So this is the button for this solenoid. Then the third button is for the one time or continuous. If it is on, either the solenoid or the this one will be functioning continuously. Okay, now we'll see it in action. Now I'm about to press. You see how fast it is functioning. Now I'm keeping an object. I'm pressing this one. You see something like a bullet action, right? The acceleration is very enormous. Then the continuous button, third button is pressed. It will be continuously functioning. You see, it hits. You see the movement, okay? Now we'll say about the linear actuator. This side, this is for the second button. Now the second button is pressed, moved 100 mm, then it comes back. Then if third button is on, continuously it will function. Okay, so this is how I made this particular demonstration. See, for pencil wending and all, or a stick wending and all, you can use this solenoid because it will hit like at a very faster rate. The acceleration is more, so just it will hit once. So yeah, pencil like object can be dispensed immediately, so fastly. This one you can use it like a biscuit packet or a soap is a rectangular box like thing, you know. So any object which is of a cubical structure or a rectangular prismatic structure, so that can be pushed using this kind of linear actuator. Even I said already, this particular linear actuator is having a pulling or pushing capacity of 10 kg. Even 30 kg motors are also available in the market. Actually, the cost of this particular one itself is somewhere around 2500 rupees or so. But you can use it in executing some projects. So dispensing, pushing or pulling, even to a small scissor type elevating platform, you can design it. Generally they use a hydraulic cylinder. Instead, you can use this one, provided it will lift a payload of up to 10 kg, not more than that. But it is so compact. Hydraulic means it's big, costlier, but hydraulic system can lift a weight even up to a ton, 100,000 kg. But okay, for demonstration purposes and all, the hydraulic system is not required. Only this will do. Okay, hope you have understood about how we can use the PLC. Even the same kind of circuit, the same kind of design, it can be made even with the help of Arduino board also, right? Arduino board also. Okay, so both are possible. Hope you understood the concept of the solenoid and the actuators, how it is working, then how this can be implemented in executing some of the projects. You have understood about all these things in today's session. Okay, kindly subscribe my channel and inform this to others, so then they'll also get some input through my session. Thank you.